today. From Hard Rock Stadium in Miami, Florida, this is Madden NFL 21 on EA Sports. We'll see Ryan Fitzpatrick and the Miami Dolphins taking on Sam Darnold and the New York Jets.
From beautiful South Florida, there's a look at Hard Rock Stadium in Miami. The excitement brewing here in South Florida as a moment ago the Dolphins starters were introduced to this home crowd. They're fired up as well as they get set to match up with the New York Jets. Ready to get us started, Sam Ficken has it teed up. And we are underway from Miami. Jakeem Grant now to return. And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line. The Dolphins offense set to take over, and it's the longtime veteran Ryan Fitzpatrick who leads the way.
Ryan Fitzpatrick's the kind of guy you want on your team in every situation, whether you want him to be your starter, whether you want him to bridge and help a rookie out like Tua Tagovailoa. It doesn't matter. He can fit every spot you're looking for. He's in the second year of a two-year deal, went 5-8 and 13 starts last year with 20 touchdown passes. And anytime he's on the field, there could be some Fitz magic.
On first and 10, Fitzpatrick completes it to the tight end, Smythe. And he's going to get a good gain of 9 here up to the 34.
When you execute a drag or a crossing route really well and give them a chance to let it develop a little bit, you can gain some significant yardage hitting your tight end on that one.
Maybe a good spot to take a shot here, second and a yard from the 34. 54 is Mike. Check, check. They'll run for the first time here with Matt Breida. And he'll bring it up here to right at the 40-yard line. 6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down.
Run there by Matt Breida, and he spent the early part of his career in San Francisco sharing the backfield and sharing the ball. What you really want with him, open space and make sure he's touching it because he can take it from zero to the end zone in a very short amount of time.
Fitzpatrick now to throw on first down. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. A Miami first down, that one going for a gain of 11. So in jet territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 49-yard line. Play action now, Fitzpatrick. And he can't find anywhere to go with it, and he goes down. Terrell Basham coming in hard that time on the blitz, and he gets him down. It's a loss of 4.
Now, we talk about players blitzing all the time. I often laugh and sometimes call it just straight-ahead pursuit. What a running start right back to the backfield for him.
Yeah, it really didn't give anybody a chance to get up there and stop him.
No, I mean, that's really, really difficult. You're asking a whole lot anyway, but when he gets that kind of a start and comes through clean, oftentimes the advantage definitely goes to the defensive player.
So after the sack here, second and 14. Working out of the gun, Fitzpatrick. That's caught by his big tight end, Mike Gesicki. And that's going to be another first down as the tackle made at the Jets' 38-yard line. 15 yards on the play, first down.
When I see Mike Gesicki make a catch, I'm reminded of his athletic ability. And go back to the time we were leading up to the draft and showing his career highlights, including high school volleyball, where he appeared he was almost jumping over the net. I expect him to continue to grow in 2020, start to make progress in 2019. Five touchdown catches and 570 total yards.
On first down, here's Breida. And the play goes nowhere. Losing yardage back near the 40 at the 39. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11.
It's a tough one right there. He ran right into the teeth of the blitz as the linebacker was freed up in order to stuff that one for a loss. I think quarterbacks got to see that, got to find a way to audible into something a little more advantageous.
Maybe just a slight detour on what's been a strong drive. Here's second and 11. Right there. From the gun, Fitzpatrick. Got a man open. That's Devontae Parker complete. And that's going to be another first down as the tackle made at the Jets' 20-yard line. From the red zone now, Fitzpatrick. Looking for his running back, and he's got him. And he'll wind up losing yardage here, back at the 21-yard line. He was unable to shake free there. They'll cover him for a loss of a yard.
Well, I know it goes against the instincts of the person catching the ball, because all you're ever taught is catch the football, don't drop it.
But drop it there.
Yeah, in that situation, dropping it would have been better. End up losing yardage, even though they completed the pass.
As good as a sack.
Yeah, how about that? Although they won't get the same credit for it, and it won't help them at contract time.
That pass play wound up for negative yardage, so here's second and 11. Now the former Washington Husky, here's Myles Gaskin. 4 yards on the pickup there as they get it back to a more manageable third and 7.
On a second and long, it's really nice to see an offense that has enough confidence to run the football in that situation. I think that goes back to their practice and game planning. They've seen things that they've seen on tape and in previous games that led them to believe that even in a long distance situation, they can still run the football and gain enough yardage to put themselves in a good spot on third down.
Looking end zone, but it's incomplete.
That was a touchdown if he could have hung on. Instead, it was a well-timed collision to jar that one free.
So on fourth down, Dolphin kicker Jason Sanders comes on. From the right hash, just a 34-yard attempt. Sanders' kick is good. And the opening drive for the Dolphins yields 3. Able to move the ball on that drive. Yes, just 3 points, but 4 first downs were in there.
Yeah, and you can look at it and feel pretty good about the whole thing and think, okay, this should continue throughout this ball game. On the flip side, if you're a defender, it's almost like, whew, we only gave up 3. They moved the ball on us pretty well.
After the field goal, here comes Sanders to kick it away. That'll be taken about a yard deep. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24. The Jets offense ready for their first possession, and they are led by the 23-year-old from USC in his third year now, quarterback Sam Darnold.
Year three now of Sam Darnold being the starting quarterback of the New York Jets, and as you might expect, some ups and downs along the way. That's what happens with young quarterbacks. Last year, 19 touchdowns, 13 interceptions, had to play through some sickness and injury. But the Jets really believe in this guy and showed it by upgrading their offensive line in order to get him more protection moving forward.
Darnold going to lead the Jets up now, first and 10 at their own 24. It's the former Hurricane great, Frank Gore. And he's going to get a good gain of 9 here up to the 34. A nice run there, 9 yards, and it'll be second down. Well, Frank Gore, of course, with ties to the city of Miami, born in Coral Gables. He played for these Dolphins for one season, 2018, and, of course, was a collegiate star at the University of Miami from 2001 to 04. And to the 42-yard line here and brought down there. That one, a first down pickup of 8.
Run there by Frank Gore, and he has to be one of the most admired players in the NFL. Started the 2020 season, number 3 all-time on the rushing list, less than 1,400 yards shy of Walter Payton as the season kicked off. Spent a year with Coach Adam Gase in Miami. Now he's hooked back up with him again with the New York Jets.
3 tight ends in the ballgame here on first and 10. Here's Gore, and 3 yards there, takes him to the 45. The last run got 3, now here's 2nd and 7. And they'll try the air now with Darnold. He's going to find his tight end. That's Chris Herndon. And he's got another first down as he's brought down at the Dolphins 42. A gain of 13. It's a first down.
When this offense can get their tight ends involved, they can move the football. Here, a nice route, able to look it in, and picks up the first down.
So now 1st and 10 as they've crossed into Miami territory at the 42-yard line. Darnold completes it, and he works it past the 30, almost to the 25. 15 more there, and they're on a roll. It's another first down.
Catch there by Jamison Crowder. 78 catches, 833 yards, and 6 touchdowns in 2019. Operates very well out of the slot, one of the niftier receivers in the league.
On 1st and 10, Darnold escaping the pressure right. The improv on the scramble there gets him 6, and it'll be 2nd down.
Now that was not a bad scramble there on 1st down. He didn't force it, nor did he throw it away. He was able to take off, and now he made it a very manageable 2nd and short.
So 2nd and 4 from the 22. They run. It's Gore. And he'll get this down close to a first down at about the Dolphins 17. A gain of 5. Good enough for the first down. Quite the opening drive march they're on right now.
It looks a lot like what we saw in practice prior to the game, doesn't it? You know, because on that last big practice beforehand, you go through your offensive script. You go through your play calling. You go through all the stuff and establish things. And it looks like it's going like clockwork right now for them.
Gore again here on 1st down. And he's going to take it in for a Jets touchdown. From 17 yards out, and the Jets have taken the lead. That almost looked too easy, and I think thanks goes to the offensive line for making it look easy.
Yeah, I agree with you totally on that one. I'm not sure how much everyone understands the preparations that go into a game for an offensive line, because there's a reason that running backs and quarterbacks give them big gifts at the end of a season after a big year. The consistency and the continuity it takes to know each other and execute their blocks is pretty impressive.
And this is up and good to make it 7-3. So that drive takes him down the field in 8 plays. And it ends with a Frank Gore touchdown run. Now Ficken to kick off following the touchdown. This is Jakeem Grant. Oh, a good return up past the 30. The Miami Dolphins, 2-3 on the year. Now they come up with one of the more surprising scorelines of Week 5, blowing away San Francisco 43-17 in Santa Clara. And the Dolphins capitalizing on a couple of Jimmy Garoppolo interceptions to build a big halftime lead. And how about Ryan Fitzpatrick, who obviously has been hearing the drumbeat for Tua get louder and louder, but he was tremendous in the win. Season high, 350 yards, 3 touchdown passes. I don't know, CD, are we underrating the Miami Dolphins?
You know, I think you can take the drumsticks and put them down for a while and let Ryan Fitzpatrick be Fitzmagic. So to answer your question, we might very well be, because their 3 losses this year, New England, Buffalo, Seattle. Think about those 3 teams and how good they have been and are. No slouches in that group at all. But now, due to schedule changes, the Dolphins can dare to dream that they can be 3-3 going into their open week, because they host the Jets in Week 6. And then, after their open week, they get a home game against the Rams. That could be huge. That could really signify and announce to the rest of the league that this Dolphins team is underrated.
Fitzpatrick on first down. Over the middle, complete. It's Ford. And this will leave him a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down.
Nothing fancy on first down, but a very consistent type of a play. Hit that slant. A lot of people call it an extension of the running game, and it can be if that pass is completed, because you hit a guy on the run like that, he often can go for big yardage.
Sets him up nicely for second down, staying ahead of schedule. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. 12 yards there and a first down. Nothing too fancy, just a carry up the middle, but a successful carry up the middle against this 3-4 defense.
And to be able to do that, what do you have to control? The nose guard, right? Got to be able to move him, otherwise you're not getting anything up the middle. Nice job by the center. Got a little help from one of his friends playing guard.
They had to settle for 3 last drive, hoping this second go-around ends in 6. In good position, 1st and 10. They'll run now with Gaskin. They'll get him to the ground at the 20 following a pickup of 4. After 1, 7-3 the score on EA Sports. The ball resting on the 20. Here's 2nd and 6. This is Gaskin on the carry. And he'll take this inside the 20 and down to the 18. It'll be a pickup of a couple, and it leaves him with a 3rd and 3.
Well, that call makes sense, because they've been throwing it well on this drive, and once again they show passing formation, showing the shotgun. Then they ran out of it. That's a nice play by them defensively, though, to hold it to a short gain.
3rd and short yardage, Fitzpatrick. And the Jets defense making things difficult there. Fourth down.
These guys had to settle for a field goal their last time moving the ball down the field. They may have to do it again on this drive. That could be frustrating.
Yeah, I don't want to be cliche, but at least they were able to get three last time. Three here, not the worst thing in the world. So out comes the field goal team now for the second time here today. And they're able to pick up the first and keep possession. It's first and goal after they rip off a solid chunk of yardage in the ground game on a risky fourth down call.
But not only do I give that staff high marks for fortitude, but how about the execution of that play? Letting the rush get upfield, wait till it gets there, and then shoveling it inside to the tight end to pick up a first down off of that field.
Looks pretty. I love the little shovels. Get the tight end involved, pick it up.
And he put it right on him too, didn't he? Let him get upfield well.
A good run of 6 yards there. Gets him closer to the goal line with second down coming up.
When you look at the geography we're staring at, this part of the field, don't you always think of big backs carrying the football, bruisers trying to pound it in? Instead, we look at a little more of a scat back type, and he's trying to make it happen.
Yeah, they went with the elusive, slippery guy. Couldn't get in there, though. They come out with one back and three tight ends. Second and three, and they trail 7-3, but getting close to changing that. This defense hoping to limit them to a field goal to preserve the lead. Toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete. You and I watched film yesterday, and you told me to watch his feet. Well, for whatever reason, his footwork just looked off on that throw.
And you always love it when an ex-defensive back talks quarterback mechanics, right?
Well, but you're good at it.
Well, I try, all right? I don't know how good I am, but it doesn't take much to tell. His mechanics are off a little bit, exactly what you described. Footwork, that led to the incompletion.
That'll be caught for a Dolphin touchdown. It's Williams. The 3-yard touchdown pass, and the Dolphins are going to jump back in front. There was no going through the progressions on that touchdown pass.
Yeah, nor was it necessary. His receiver won that route early, presented himself. No reason to wait. Go ahead and put it on him and score a touchdown.
Jason Sanders now for the extra point. It's through, and that makes the lead 10-7. So that one a pretty time-consuming 10-play drive. And it winds up in 6 points for the Dolphins. Now after the touchdown, ready to kick it away is Sanders. Returnable here for Davis. And they will wrangle it down a couple yards shy of the 30. And our focus now shifts to Frank Gore. He's been good. They've utilized him well, but they're losing here in the second quarter. What might they change offensively?
I think that what you try and do is expand how you get the ball to him a little bit. Get him out in open space, maybe swing the ball to him. What's that they used to call it in the West Coast offense, the long handoff?
Yeah.
Serve as your running play that way, as well as continue to feed him the football. Some of these runs now may pop bigger later in the game because of the effects of running it. Sometimes people, after a while, they don't want to tackle him anymore, or they get tired, or they get out of position, or he runs through tackles. Continue to feed him the ball. He's having that kind of game.
Yeah, might they get him the ball in some space in some different ways here?
Well, that one was all about the defender making life difficult for the receiver. Very tough for a guy to hold on to the football through all that contact. He ends up forcing the incompletion.
So now they'll come up on second and 10, once again from the 28. A shotgun snap for Darnold. He finds Smith out of the backfield. And he'll be tackled right on the chalk of the 45. That one good for a first down pickup of 18 yards.
You can see the time and effort and thought that they've put into their passing game because it was evident right there. It looks like a simple pitch and catch, but you and I both know that they have planned for this and worked hard to make it happen.
First down, it's Gore. And not a lot of daylight, not really any daylight inside, as he's going to be stopped right at the line of scrimmage. Brings up second down. He can rack up those tackles in bunches in the run game from that middle linebacker spot.
And what he has to do is make sure he congratulates the guys in front and tells them thanks a lot, because as the guy in the middle, the Mike linebacker, you're counting on your front three, your front four, your front five, whatever you've got in front of you, to take up all the blocking, allow you to roam and hit, and that's what he did on that play.
4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a third down.
Fired that one in there, able to make connection on a nice in route.
With those faster passes, when they're going that fast, any hesitation as a quarterback that the deflection, if you miss, might be bigger and lead to an interception?
Yeah, and the deflection works both ways. Maybe a defender gets a hand in the way and it pops in the air, and sometimes you throw it so hard your receiver can't handle it, and he pops it up in the air for the defenders to grab as well.
But a moot point there as they were able to connect. Back-to-back receptions for him, and it's another first down.
One of the selling points of the in route is it gives the quarterback a really nice sight line to his receiver, and almost on a direct shot, able to throw the ball into the middle of the field and have a great chance of success, as they did on that play.
So now first and 10 as they've crossed into Miami territory at the 35-yard line. Darnold from the gun. Got a man. It's Breshad Perriman. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. 10 more there and another first down.
Completion there to Breshad Perriman. And the best part of his game coming out of UCF, his ability to run. A sub-4.4 sprinter. They need him now in New York to replace speedster Robbie Anderson, who signed with Carolina. He's going to take over the outside vertical routes that Anderson provided, and they're hoping for big plays downfield.
He had to fight that time. Ran through one tackle, but ultimately he's only going to get back to the line of scrimmage. This defense, tough to run against. And those linebackers, they'll go side to side up the field, and there they get them for no gain.
If you can't get linemen upfield to the second level to occupy them, they have a field day just running to the football and putting ball carriers on the ground. Not many yards after contact when they wrap up like that.
So after the run for no gain, here's second and 10. Here's Gore now, running out of the gun. And a good run as he manages 7 yards down to the 17.
Well, there's an example of patience being rewarded. Ran the ball on first down and got stuffed. Most people would scream, throw the ball here in this situation. They stayed with their roots, stayed with running the football, and they got rewarded.
The eighth play of the drive coming up. It's 3rd and 3. They'll try and pick up the first with Gore. And boy, he is very close to a first down, but from where they're spotting that football, he's going to be a foot or so short. The ball's still a few inches shy of the marker after the 3-yard run, so now a little soul searching on fourth down. And no field goal try here from the red zone. Offense out there. They'll go for it on fourth. They snap it. They're going for it. Here's Darnold. And that is incomplete, but there is a flag. And on fourth down, this is a big call.
Let's go.
So the contact came before the ball got there, and the flag is thrown.
Timing is everything, isn't it? And it's so hard to cover these great receivers. They have such great body control, and they can fake you out. In this case, as you described, got there before the ball got to the receiver. Penalty flag had to come out.
They'll try and push it in with Gore. And he is in. Touchdown, New York. Frank Gore with his second touchdown here in this first half. And the Jets have once again taken the lead. And always a good first half when you can hit pay dirt twice.
And it never hurts to have that good feeling as the game moves on. Just think about halftime. If that's all he gets, he'll just sit there at the half and think, all right, two already. I can get some more. And he'll be encouraging his offensive line to create some space.
For the point after, Sam Ficken. And that makes it 14-10. A 10-play drive that time. And it ends with a Frank Gore touchdown run. Now Ficken to kick off following the touchdown. That'll be taken about a yard deep. And the tackle going to be made right there at the 25-yard line.
In his face!
Out comes the Miami offensive unit now. They get set to take over. After the long touchdown drive we just saw, you wonder if maybe that's taken a little of the wind out of this offensive sails, because they had it going pretty good last time, too.
Had to sit over there for a little while, didn't they? You know, they were eager, amped up to get back on the field after just scoring, hoping to get the ball back quickly. That didn't happen, so I'd say come out, just kind of get started again. You know, it doesn't have to be anything dramatic. Just get moving, get loose again, and see if they can get it downfield.
Here's Gaskin. Room here to run. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. 16 yards right off the bat and a first down. Good push up front in that run in between the tackles.
Let's play the leverage game here. Offensive line just got lower than the defensive front, and they were able to get their pads on them and move them backwards and create space for their running back to roam.
One play has him up past the 40 already, and another first and 10. Running out of the gun here, Breida. And they'll get to him after a gain of 7 to the 47.
Good yardage there on first down, exactly what you want. Get yourself set up to keep making first downs, keep the clock running. And if they're smart, you're starting to milk the clock. No hurry before you run your second down play.
A good run, got 7 on first. Here's second and 3. From the shotgun, it's Fitzpatrick. Throwing over the middle, and it's incomplete. He was looking for his tight end, Mike Gesicki, and it's third and short. By the way, I got to apologize because I just realized for about the last 4 or 5 plays, I'm eking over into your territory up here in the booth. My bad. I'm going to get back over to my spot.
Yeah, and we're not talking about our on-air commentary. I mean, what is all this extra paper? I mean, this is unusual for you.
My bad.
Normally, you run a really tight ship. What's going on here?
Just like that incomplete pass, I'm going to try to tighten things up here for this next play. Got a man. It's complete. Williams. And he's going to have a first down as he's brought down at the 44-yard line. So in Jet territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 44-yard line. On the handoff, it's Gaskin, and he's going to get stopped up quickly. Give him a yard down to the 43.
No doubt about it. A really nice job there by the defense, not allowing him to get to the perimeter. But that means your defensive ends, your outside linebackers, the guys that you pay big money to sack the quarterback, they also have to have interest in the running game as well. And they did a nice job there of holding the point of attack and not giving ground.
Two minutes remaining in this first half of football. A reminder that when halftime rolls around, Jonathan Coachman will have all the highlights and analysis of this first half of play from our studios in Orlando. Only 3 yards on the catch. It's third down.
That was an okay hookup there with his tight end, but unfortunately, they didn't get the kind of yards they had hoped for. That's going to bring up third down.
They'll get to the line here, but remember, it's also third down.
46 to Mike, 46.
From the gun, Fitzpatrick. Well, this is going to depend on the spot, but it's not a very generous one. He looks to be about a yard or so short. The Jets are going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. Would have been right at about a 52-yard field goal try, but no, they are going to go for this thing on fourth down. They'll try and run for it. And he gets it to the 32, good enough for a first down. They only got a couple, but a couple's all that they needed as they convert on fourth. At first glance, I actually wasn't sure that he got it, but he ended up getting it by about a full yard.
He certainly did, but it took a little effort, didn't it? Took some nice push, a little crease inside, and some determined running to make sure that he got the first down.
Fitzpatrick throwing complete. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. Now the Dolphins going to burn the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with just over a minute to go before halftime. So from the 17 now, here's a first and 10. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. How about the big boys snagging one? You don't see that every week.
No, you don't, but a lot of them are just reliving their old dreams, going back to when they were in youth football and in high school. They didn't always play defensive line. Some of them actually handled the football, and you can see the flashback when he grabbed that one.
Well, for the New York Jets, a familiar refrain here in 2020, dominated again in week 5, this time at the hands of the Arizona Cardinals, 30-10, the Jets falling at home, and now 0-5. It's first time since 1996 they finished that season 1-15. But Joe Flacco, Charles, he subs for the injured Sam Darnold, making his first start as a Jet. And probably the first start since week 8 of last year as a Bronco, right?
Yeah, you're exactly right. And, you know, he couldn't get a whole lot going. 195 yards and a touchdown. They got Le'Veon Bell back, but this team right now, let's face it, they're going nowhere fast. Major league struggles. Now, schedule changes have kicked in for them. So now this week, they'll play at the Dolphins, then they're home for Buffalo, and then at Kansas City. I'm not sure where I'm seeing the light for this team. Most of us thought they and the Dolphins would be very competitive. Right now, the Dolphins look like a decided favorite.
Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. Out of the shotgun, here's Darnold. And the coverage terrific there as that's knocked down and incomplete. He was looking for Jamison Crowder there. And that'll bring up second down.
So many times when we talk about coverage, we're just about a defender running with a receiver. But a big part of it is understanding where the football is, finding it. In this case, when it arrived, it wasn't a surprise. And he was able to bat it away.
Back to the air, Darnold on second down. He's got this one complete to Perriman. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. It's a pickup of 17 and a first down.
Good strong throw and catch right there. And so far in this game, the alleys have been open for them to get completions, and they're taking advantage of it.
First down, Darnold. And he's going to find his man out of the backfield. That's complete. The Jets going to go ahead and use their final timeout as they'll stop it with 14 seconds to go in this first half. That pass play wound up for negative yardage. So here's second and 11. Now a delayed give to Gore. And he's across midfield and into Miami territory. Nifty running there, but it'll come on what should be the final play of half number one. So we've reached halftime here in a four-point game. As we go up to Orlando now and hand it over to Jonathan Coachman with our EA Sports Halftime Report. Take it away, Coach.
All right, Brandon, thanks very much. Welcome, everybody, to our abbreviated version of the EA Sports Halftime Report. Okay, Brandon, thanks very much, and welcome, everyone, to this abridged version of the EA Sports Halftime Report. This one has been a hard-hitting affair to this point, and you gotta expect we'll see more of the same in the second half. And to bring the action your way, let's get it right back out to Brandon Godden.
All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. And the Jets set to receive this third quarter kickoff, and they have the lead as well as we are underway in the second half. Returnable here for Davis. And he takes this near the 25, just a little pass there, call it the 26. Frank Gore and company trotting back out there as they get set to go again on offense. And he's found the end zone twice, and now I'm guessing he's thinking, hey, let's find it three times.
And you got to figure from the defensive perspective, how has he gotten there twice? What are we going to do to keep him out for a third time? How do we tighten things down? Because he and his offensive mates, they are really in sync right now.
Jets offense coming up now to start their next drive. They have the lead. Now they'll be looking for some separation here as we begin the third quarter.
I like the way you turn that, because now I think they go a little bit deeper into their playbook. They like what they did in the first half. That worked okay. But in order to get the separation that you just talked about, change things up a little bit. Change your tendencies. Try and hit them a little bit more with some things they didn't see in the first half.
We'll see if they do just that. Able to get seven on that first down pass play. Second and three. Off of play action, Darnold. And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect. He was trying to find his tight end, Chris Herndon. And it's third and short.
Well, you got to think that sooner or later, they're going to hit one of those. But the coverage has been excellent thus far. And it was again on the last play.
So the incomplete pass on the last play, and that leads us to a third and three. Here's Darnold. He dumps this off underneath to Gore. And he's got the first down yardage before he's brought down at the 42. It's an 8-yard pickup and leads to a new set of downs.
As you know, so many things in the passing game are based on yardage. Sometimes it's just based on timing, and that's what we saw right there on that play. Third and three, just get the ball right to the receiver.
It's the hitch route. And tell us, what is the hitch route?
Yeah, just take really one step, like you're driving off the line of scrimmage, get the defensive back on his heels, get the ball out to the receiver, and he does the rest.
first down, it's Darnold. And he's got his man out of the backfield. That's complete. And to the 42-yard line here and brought down there. A good rally to the football keeps him to only a yard, and it's second down.
All defenses worry that whenever anyone catches the ball and has a head of steam come out of the backfield, it could turn into a big play with missed tackles or he runs through people. But they were right there waiting, and they stopped him for a minimal gain.
Now it's Gore. And give him about five as he gets this up to the 48-yard line.
Frustrating for a defense, energizing for an offense. Finding a way to create that type of yardage in your running game, that'll make the guys carrying the ball very, very happy.
And the Dolphins beef up the secondary here as they look to stop him on third down. Back to throw, Darnold. Under pressure here, and down he goes. Sacked back at about the 43-yard line.
That's exactly what they were looking for coming out to start the third quarter. Get a sack, get off the field, get the momentum going in their direction.
Get the ball back to your offense, right? Get that momentum because, hey, this lead is very, very slim. Here's the Jets punter now. And surprisingly, this is the first punt of the game for either team. And did they keep it in? They did. They kept it in. It's down close to the goal line at the 1 yard line. Amazing. Perfectly placed. If that ball goes one extra yard, maybe not even an extra yard, the starting point is the 20.
So there is a reason that a lot of punters are also excellent golfers. They know distance control. You know what else they have? Same groove motion over and over. Once they have that down, it repeats under pressure.
And he'll give it here to his running back. And he'll take this up to about the 7 or 8 yard line. A solid run on first down. Gain of 7 leaves him with a 2nd and 3.
But both teams practice this situation. And this time, the guys on offense won and in a very nice way. What a run from that position on their own goal line.
Gave him some good breathing room.
I wonder now, do you still stack the line of scrimmage or do you play normal defense? They may have backed him off with that run.
Throwing on 2nd and 3. Fitzpatrick, and he goes down. It's a sack. They get him back at his own 3-yard line. Steve McClendon, credit him for the sack.
I think most quarterbacks would love to have the goal line actually extend up into the air and turn into a wall. They can put their back against it and know exactly where they are on the field so they don't end up in the end zone. Didn't do it on that play, but perilously close to the goal line.
Facing the prospect of a punt from their own end zone, they need some cushion. Let's see what they can do on third down. Now a handoff here to his running back. And able to get it across the 10 to the 15. That'll go for a gain of 13, helping big time to get away from that end zone. First down.
So that's what that elbow in my ribs was all about. You thought they were going to throw the ball as well.
Absolutely. I think everybody thought they were throwing the football. Caught him off guard.
Yeah, I'm telling you, when you have the courage to make that type of a play call, a lot of times you actually get rewarded.
Line of scrimmage, the 15. It's 1st and 10. Another run with Gaskin. And he's taken down, but not before he gets this across the 25-yard line. 11 more on that one, and another first down.
That was good, tough running right up the middle. And if the defense can't penetrate and make him slow his pace or change direction, that's often the end result.
First down, Fitzpatrick. That's complete to his tight end, Mike Gesicki. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down. Not a big window to throw. Coverage wasn't too bad there.
Yeah, they had him under wraps pretty well, but somehow able to muscle his way open and catch the ball.
Second and five after the 5 yard completion on first down. Working out of the gun, Fitzpatrick. A thrown to Parker, complete on the slant. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40 yard line. 11 yards there, first down.
Nice snag by Devontae Parker. While it took him 5 years in the league to have his first 1,000 yard season, he broke out in a big way. The former first round pick had career highs across the board in 2019. In fact, his touchdown total for the year equaled his career total to date.
And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. Another catch for him there. This one good for 11, first down. So in Jet territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 46. Going to give this time to the tailback. And he's going to get this inside the 30. 17 more yards on that one as they keep the drive rolling.
I hope we give enough respect to the big guys up front because they have been getting it done on this drive. The holes have been large, and they've been barreling through them, picking up first downs.
Right back to him on first down, down to the 25. Avery Williamson there to make the stop.
He's had success on this drive, but not on this play.
Finally, they bowed up defensively. I think they were determined not to let him take it pretty much all the way down the field.
Yeah, it looks like they handled their run responsibilities correctly this time. What we call them, run fits, everyone was in the right place.
From the 25 on second down, Fitzpatrick, he's got the first down inside the 10. And he'll take this into the end zone for a Dolphins touchdown. Preston Williams, his second touchdown of the afternoon as his guys are able to regain the lead.
I know we often laugh and sometimes we even exalt the guys who are great trash talkers and give us some really funny lines. But the bottom line is absolute production on the field. His second touchdown of the game, and they lead.
And now they'll be looking to their defense to preserve that lead. Sanders on for the extra point. It's good, and they'll take a 17-14 lead. So that one, a pretty time-consuming 10-play drive. And it ends with a touchdown for the Dolphins. Now after the touchdown, ready to kick it away is Sanders. Returnable here for Davis. And able to get this across the 20, but not much further as he's dropped at the 23-yard line. Back on offense, New York gets set to take over. They punted last time they had it. What steps, Charles, you think they have to take to make sure they don't do that again?
Well, let's just go to the football 101, the trite expression 101. Win first down. Make 5, 6, 7 yards on first down and make it a 2nd and 3, 2nd and manageable. Keep accumulating first downs that way. Keep moving the football. You don't want to get behind the sticks because then the defense has the advantage.
Darnold going to lead the Jets up now, first and 10 at their own 23. Out of the gun, he'll throw. Forced out to his left. And now he's going to use his legs. The improv on the scramble there gets him six, and it'll be second down. Now on second down, this is Gore. And tackled down after a gain of three, leaves him with 1 yard to go on third down. Well, that's some good tackling there to keep him short of that yellow line.
Yeah, defensively, all I'm thinking is that on that play, get me to third down. Get me into a position where I can make one more play and get my defense off the field.
Another carry now for Gore. And he's able to get the first before he's taken down at the 36. Just 4 yards on the pickup, but that's good enough to extend the drive.
Everyone understood their role on that play. Third and one, you know, the defensive guys, they're trying to get down and get low and get leverage on the offensive lineman, but they didn't allow that to happen. They created a crease and allowed him to get through for a first down.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. Darnold. Looking for Perriman there. He's got him. And he's able to get this to the 40-yard line before he's out of bounds. Call that a very strong gain of 24.
Now that was pretty. They executed that curl route versus zone coverage. And that changes things a little bit because against man, it's often a tight curl, tight, sharply run route. Against zone, you're just looking for that open spot, that dead area. So you may curl it a little bit wider just to get to that place.
And usually a tight window. He fired a bullet in there for the completion. Under a minute to go in this third quarter as they come up first and 10. Now it's Darnold. The Dolphins get there this time, and they bring him down. You never want to give up a sack. From the O-line's perspective, they hate it for several reasons, especially because they felt like they let little brother down back there in the pocket.
Oh, no doubt. They have a ton of pride, and they go into every job wanting to keep that guy clean. They want that uniform with no grass stains, no dirt, nothing on it, but it's really, really difficult. You're talking about some terrific athletes who are trying to put him on the ground.
Protection certainly going to need to be a bit better here on second and 16. A play fake, and it's Darnold. Wide open receiver complete. And he's got another first down as he's brought down at the Dolphins 18. A gain of 28 yards there, and give him a first down. Is going to do it for this third quarter of action. You are watching the NFL on EA Sports. So from inside the 20, here's first and 10 at the 18. Now a draw play for Gore. And he'll get this down only to the 18. Credit him with a 1 yard gain there to make it second and 9. Here's second and 9, just a yard on that last run. Darnold now to throw. He's going to hit his man out of the backfield, complete. And he'll get it here to the 10-yard line. That'll leave them with a third and two coming up. They got 8 yards there.
For a second there, I thought that might break big. Screen pass. Looked like it was coming together. Looked like there was an opening. Still, ended up with a solid game.
The Jets on third down. They've converted 3 out of 5 thus far. This time they face a third and two. Meanwhile, on third down, they take a shot at the end zone, but it's incomplete.
Once you get into the red zone, space is at a premium for receivers to try and operate and shake themselves free. That one's incomplete.
So on fourth down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. Ficken's kick is good. And in the fourth quarter, this game is tied. I tell you, the life of a kicker. He has not been called on the entire game. He's over there by the net, but they send him out here in the fourth quarter and say, hey, go tie the game, will you? And guess what? He comes through.
I just don't know how they do it. I really don't. These cats are a different breed from you and me. That's a pressure kick, but that one was never in doubt.
...17-17 the score, all even to this point as the kick's away. Here comes Grant on the return. A solid return, pretty good field position. They'll start at the 32. Miami set to take over, and we essentially have a brand new ball game. After that last field goal has tied us all up, we brace for what should be an exciting rest of this fourth quarter. From the 32 now, here's 1st and 10. And he'll give it here to his running back. And takes this one across the 35 to the 36, a gain of about 4.
Some of the most unselfish players on any football team, defensive tackles, because we ask them to just eat up blocks and allow other people to make tackles. But when he can make a play himself, as we just saw there, that's a big day.
From the 36, Fitzpatrick throwing middle, and it's complete. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down.
And he's the epitome of what we call the move tight end, the guy that you can line up anywhere, in the slot, out wide, in tight, doesn't really matter. Because he has such great skills, you want to utilize him in all aspects of your passing offense.
And there he was in the slot for the catch. On 1st and 10, Fitzpatrick. And that'll be knocked away. It's incomplete.
It's always tough for the guys throwing the football when they think they've got a completion and the ball's almost there, and then someone sneaks a hand or two in and bats it away.
After the incomplete pass, here now is 2nd and 10. Now a handoff here to his running back. And a minimal gain here as he's up to about the 47-yard line. They do get a couple, but they'll be left staring at a 3rd and 8 coming up.
Ladies and gentlemen, that is a force of nature at the defensive tackle position. Yes, he's as big as they come, but still plenty agile. He's able to make a nice play there to swallow up the ball carrier.
The Dolphins on 3rd down. They've hit it 50%, 3 of 6 to this point. This is 3rd and 8. Oh, he may have gotten lucky. Tried to dump it off underneath on the check down. Nearly picked. Instead, it's incomplete.
No coverage bust by the defense here. They did a nice job accounting for everybody, and that led to an incompletion.
Here's Matt Hawk now, as he's on to punt for the first time this afternoon. This is away, but boy, headed straight for the sidelines. And the punt over the side in the air, and the spot will be inside the 35. The Jets offensive unit ready to get going here. Excellent job by their defense to force the punt and provide them with this opportunity, all tied in the fourth quarter. Darnold going to lead the Jets up now, first and 10 at the 34. He'll throw from the gun. He's going to find his running back. It's complete. That catch good for only a couple. Line of scrimmage, the 36 on second and 8. A shotgun snap for Darnold. Looking for his running back, and he's got him. And he'll be out of bounds after getting this one across the 40.
So many times you hear today's NFL described as a space game. Get your best players into space with the football in their hands. That's why sometimes you just swing it out to your runner, get him out in the flat, and let him have a chance to make people miss an open field.
Back to the workhorse today. It's Gore. And this effort won't be enough as they rally up to stop him a couple of yards short. Just a one-yard pickup there, and it'll be fourth down. This late in the game, Charles, I think you maybe seriously have to think about going for it.
Especially where they are in terms of field position, because this is almost like no man's land. Might hurt your punter because there might not be enough space, maybe too far for your field goal kicker. I'm like the old rule. Possession is 9/10 of the law. Possession is 9/10 of winning the game. Go for it. Get the first down. Close it out.
Here's the Jets punter now as he's on to kick it away. So a change of possession here on the punt, and it'll be Dolphin football. Out comes the Miami offensive unit now. They get set to take over. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
So the ball down to the 16 here for first and 10. From the gun, Fitzpatrick. Got his man complete over the middle. That's Ford. And way up past the 35 before he's taken down. 22 yards on the catch and run, a first down. One play has him to the 37 here for first and 10. Out of the shotgun, Breida. Jordan Jenkins there on the tackle.
Certainly a nice job there by the defense rallying to the football and getting him on the ground, but I think the play gets made by the defensive front because if they can't get upfield, their job is to go ahead and get low, almost get into a ball sometimes, stack things up, and make it difficult for the runner to find a hole.
From the 40 now on second down, Fitzpatrick. Quick hitter here, it's complete. 4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a third down.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you've got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go because he might wander into some tough coverage.
The Dolphins on third down, 3 for 7 so far in this game. This time it's 3rd and 3. That'll be complete to Breida. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. Give him 12 yards there, and the Dolphins have a first down.
Short yardage situation, you have to wonder if they thought that they were just going to run it inside. But you have to be cognizant of the back slipping out of the backfield trying to find some open space. And that's exactly what he does to the tune of a first down.
So in Jet territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 44-yard line. Here's Fitzpatrick. Now a short one to Gesicki. 3 yards the gain there, second down.
Completion was given up, but that's why you play zone defense, so that you can have people around the ball when it's caught, and you don't give up much run after the catch.
That first down completion only netted him 3. Second and 7. Play action now. Fitzpatrick. And his throw is going to be incomplete. Preston Williams, the intended receiver. And that takes us from second to third down. And that one going to be off target and incomplete. The Dolphins on third down. They're at 50%, 4 for 8. This is 3rd and 7. Fitzpatrick again. He'll get this into the hands of Breida. And that's going to be another first down as the tackle made at the Jets 28. That one good for 13 at a Dolphin first down.
And this is why trying to cover the angle route is so difficult. Anyone playing the linebacker position, when they see a running back out of the backfield widen because he heads towards the flat first, oftentimes you widen too much and overcommit. He cuts up inside, and that's what we saw there. A nice pickup for a first down.
Going to give this time to the tailback. Down right around the 25. It's Steve McClendon that time who winds up getting him down. Right 3 yards on that last carry. Here's 2nd and 7. Fitzpatrick now. Oh, no, he lost the football. And the Jets have recovered.
Well, so much for the 4-minute offense. They were trying to reduce the clock, get in position to win the game, and leave no time for them to come back and catch them. And guess what? They turned the ball over.
Yeah,
I mean, they had it all set up for themselves, and they let it get away.
New York set to take the field. The fumble recovery certainly has put them in the driver's seat. 1st and 10, all tied here in the 4th. Darnold going to lead the Jets up now. 1st and 10 at about the 32. So following the fumble recovery, here's Darnold. Throwing right, and that's complete. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. 1st down yardage on the first play of the drive. Give him 14. Getting down to the good stuff. All tied with 2 minutes remaining on EA Sports. So it's Jets football as we get you reset here. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. Now throwing on 1st down and completing it. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8-yard gain, 2nd and 2.
But they picked up a little bit of yardage there, and now, in this situation, should be in no hurry to run a play really fast. Let the clock wind down.
And it's a rush to the line right now for the Jets. Darnold. And this is going to be intercepted. It's the Pro Bowler, Byron Jones.
Come on, guys, let's go.
So how about that for a momentum switch?
We're in the 4th quarter, and it's a tie game. You've got to take care of the football here. Now their opportunity to take the lead right out the window, and everything is flipped in the other direction.
Now we'll see what the big tight end Mike Gesicki and the rest of the offense has in store. So after he looked really good early, they haven't been able to find the big tight end as much. What gives?
Well, sometimes that's not in the game plan defensively. They're trying to take away other people, or they weren't expecting him to get off to such a hot start. But now they know he's out there. They've made a few adjustments, surround him with a few more people, a few different coverages. Let's see if he makes the adjustments now. Does he change up a few things to try and work his way open?
Good starting field position for the Dolphins as they have it first and 10 at their own 44. Now he's going to send this one deep right side. And this is going to be intercepted. Picked off inside the 10.
Well, I tell you, you can't fault the pass protection here. He had all day to throw, and he just couldn't find anywhere to go with the football. And quarterbacks will tell you that after a while, they start getting antsy back there. So this is just a great job defensively to stay with these receivers as long as they did.
The offense for the Jets ready to take over. They've got work to do, but they do still have a bit of time here.
And they've got to feel comfortable with that, but they have all their play sequences called. If they get out of bounds, that allows them to huddle and call another play. But if they don't, it's hurry up to the line of scrimmage and either spike it and stop the clock or continue to move it downfield in order to try and get in range and win this game.
See if they can do just that. After the interception, here's Darnold. Crowder's got it over the middle. That one good for 10 yards, and that'll make it second and a foot or so. Well, that's a good first step, but several steps still to go.
They still have time for the possible game-winning field goal. Time for them to be quick and hurry at the same time.
Options galore here, second and a few inches. Now it's Darnold. His throw incomplete. Complete pass on second down leads us to third and inches. Gore. And he's able to pick up the first down here before he goes down at the 26. It's a 9-yard gain and it keeps the drive moving.
They're probably about one big play from getting into field goal range. I'd go with a 2-deep coverage, make sure my safeties are back to cover all of the field deep.
First down now, but that clock rolling. Play action. It's Darnold going deep now for Herndon. And this is incomplete with a clock showing just 3 seconds left. Once again, they'll come up on the 26-yard line, second and 10. Here's Gore, and he'll take this for a short gain on what will prove to be the final play of this ball game. And here in overtime, if the team that receives the ball scores a touchdown, it's over. If they don't, we can still have some more football.
That's exactly right. If they go down and kick a field goal, the other team gets a possession to either match it or score a touchdown to win the ball game. If both teams kick field goals, the next team to score wins. But if the receiving team throws a pick six or fumbles the ball and it gets picked up by the defense and they score, the game is over at that point.
So a tie ball game here as the kick's away. Returnable here for Davis. And he brings this out past the 20 to the 24. And the Jets set to take the field. They're set for their first drive here in overtime. And this is where the crowd can really become a factor.
They've had to battle it all day, but I know what you're saying. In overtime, that gets doubled, doesn't it? At least, because now the crowd really wants to be involved and help their team. And that first drive can dictate the whole thing, because they know if this team takes it downfield and scores a touchdown, it's game over.
It's been loud in here so far. Darnold going to lead the Jets up now, first and 10 at their own 24. He'll drop to throw, and this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage back at the 22. Officially, it's a one-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11. He's had some big runs in this game. Not there, though.
But I don't think they're going to be deterred by that play right there. He's had some nice runs in the game. And how many times have we seen a good running back get stopped, yet turn it into something big on a later carry? I'd stay with him.
A loss of a yard there to start out. That leads to a second and 11. Darnold, his first throw in overtime. And Darnold, he lost the football. And the Dolphins have got it. And a costly, costly mistake. Coaches talk so much about ball security, and in overtime, so paramount.
Partner, do you ever wonder if maybe they talk about it too much?
Too much, yeah.
Doesn't seem like you can, but maybe by discussing it time and time again, and you know they overemphasized it here, it almost became self-fulfilling.
And any points beat them here, field goal or a touchdown now. So the ball down to the 16 here for first and 10. This is Breida on the draw, pushing through the contact. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down, second and right at a yard. And I know you, with every carry, especially in overtime, you're just saying, if you're that ball carrier, hold on to the football.
Hold on to it, protect it, but not necessarily settling, because you're trying to get to the end zone. You're trying to end the game right here. And I know the defensive guys poking, clawing, raking, trying to knock the ball free and protect their end zone.
Yeah, like you alluded to, especially this part of the field. And he's able to get it down to the 2-yard line. 4 yards on the play. That's going to lead to first and goal. They got the ball in great field position after the fumble, but this defense tried to stand tall.
They certainly are, and a lot of times after you pick up a fumble or get an interception, you have momentum on your side. You kind of walk through a defense and score. Not so fast, not in this case.
They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And they will stop him after a fairly minimal pickup. Give him 2 yards on that one, second and goal now. And that carry probably not so much for yardage, just to get the spot that you want to kick the field goal.
And any yardage you gain there is really kind of gravy. And this just becomes what my old coach used to say, get into position to be in position. And that's what they want, the right spot for their kicker to line up the field goal.
Extra bulk up front for second and inches. 3 tight ends. Try to punch it in with Howard. And he takes it into the end zone for the Dolphin touchdown. To see and making it extra special. Not only did I get 4 quarters with you in this one, I got some overtime, a little whipped cream on top.
Look at you, trying to make this whole thing palatable.
I just want you to pay for my meal later.
You really just wanted 4 quarters, what you wanted. But how much fun was that? We had that type of a game where we got us to overtime, and then we get the dramatic ending to finish things off as well. What a game.
So that'll just about do it for Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, log on to easports.com. The Dolphins are winners here as we say so long from South Florida.